institutional quarantine has been waived off, provided people upload the negative RT-PCR test result on the given website, newdelhiairport.india website, which is again given in our FAQs, which is given in our website as well. But governments, state governments, central government would recommend home quarantine just for the safety of their own self, the safety of their relatives, friends in India, to isolate themselves at least for about 7 days. Again, it varies from state to state depending on the COVID situation in each state and each city. But institutional quarantine has been waived off, provided a RT-PCR negative test result is up.
Excellent, excellent. Then there is a general question on OCI. People who have the OCI have not yet reached 50, but their passport, they've had to change their passport. Can they still continue to travel with the old passport and the new passport without having to get reapply for the OCI to be attached to the new passport?
Certainly they can travel. They have to carry their OCI card, the old passport on which the OCI card was issued, and the new passport, new valid passport, they are allowed to travel. But right now, the OCI renewal has been deferred till June 30th this year. They can travel with the existing OCI and the passport on which the OCI card is issued, and the new passport they have. Probably post June 20th, we don't know what the scenario would be, but right now they can travel with the existing.
That is for those who have crossed 50 years of age, Rajesh, no?
For all, sir.
Who have to change the passport.
Yes, sir. For all, sir. For the one valid OCI also expected to renew their OCI, they can also travel in the old OCI.
And when turning 50, they still have a valid passport. And they have to reapply and get the OCI renewed. Is that correct? At age 50?
Under normal circumstances, yes. Once people turn 50, they are supposed to renew their OCI, which takes about 2 to 3 weeks at our end. Just have to renew their OCI for the rest of their life. For a simple reason than change of appearance and other change in personal particular. But right now, because of the COVID, that condition has also been relaxed.
Okay. So basically, just to emphasize, as there were many, many questions, if you are an OCI holder, you can travel with your and have renewed your passport and have a new passport. You can travel with your new passport, but carry your old passport with you and the OCI card, and there won't be any issue. When you turn 50, you have to reapply and get your OCI renewed, which takes about 2 to 3 weeks, so that your renewal happens at turning age 50. And so all passport holders, whether you are a young person under 20 or an adult, you can travel with your old passport and the new passport without any restriction, not having to get your OCI stamped on your new passport.
Yes, but now to carry their old OCI card.
Right.
OCI. Yeah, right.
Yes, absolutely. Yes. And for new applicants for an OCI, what is the current situation? How long is it taking for the office to process new applications?
Rajji, OCI is a kind of a permanent status given to a traveler from from a foreign country to India. It's a very elaborate process, and it is not meant to be an emergency process. Actually, it has several checks, several ailment process in it, especially the one who gets the OCI issued for the first time. So it is taking about 7 to 8 weeks at present. Of course, sometimes COVID restrictions and health protocols that we have to follow adding to the delay as well. But fairly, people should keep at least 2 months time before they plan to get a new OCI.
Okay, very good. Then there's a question about renunciation of old passport or Indian citizenship. If a person cannot find their old passport and does not have any documentation to have renunciated their citizenship, is there a process whereby they can still apply for OCI, not being able to find their old Indian passport?
Rajji, but renunciation is a must if they are, of course, claiming OCI. If they had held Indian citizenship in the past and they want to apply and get an OCI card. But we naturally assume when person acquires foreign citizenship, he surrenders Indian passport or Indian citizenship through this mandated process. But in case someone has lost the passport and all that, I request my colleague who handles renunciation, who has far better knowledge than me, to intervene and guide us as to how one can go about that. Pushpaji, can you just...
Yes, sir. Good morning, everybody. In fact, about this renunciation, they can submit some documents to prove that they are of Indian origin, like birth certificate, school certificate, school living certificates, or college certificates. So there is a checklist which they can go through and submit with those documents. The application will be accepted based on that.
I wanted to add that renunciation is also mandatory for visa, not just for OCI.
Mr. Raj, no, I wanted to mention to you, recently we had a case wherein he openly said that, no, I'm unable to find my, this when it was 57 or something like that. Then when we insisted, you don't believe he could get the passport copy somewhere, no. So that really helps us. The other documents, what Pushpa was mentioning, yes, they are welcome to submit, but no, it takes time and then one has to check the veracity, etc. See, it's after all, no, it's the Government of India, Ministry of Home Affairs, who have to be satisfied with these documents of Indian origin. Just I wanted to mention.
Sure, sure, sure. So, Sumati, you mentioned that even when they apply for a visa, they have to have renunciation.
Yes, that is correct.
Even if it's a US passport holder?
Yes, if they are of Indian origin, if they are naturalized US citizens, that means their previous nationality was Indian, then they need to attach a copy of the renunciation certificate with the visa application.
Okay. And how long does it take to get the renunciation certificate currently?
If you want the renunciation certificate, we have kept an upper limit of 4 weeks, 30 days, but currently we are issuing it in 15 days. We have brought it down. We had a huge surge in application. We brought it down from 30 to 15 days now. But for the one who wants to apply for visa, a renunciation certificate is not necessary, in the sense that they can apply for renunciation, attach their fee receipt, and then apply for visa. They need not have to wait for 15 days to get the certificate to apply for visa. But for OCI, it is necessary to have a renunciation certificate and proceed.
Many questions on OCI and people turning 50. Any further explanation on that, I think, would help, especially.
I would suggest, if people do not foresee any travel in the next 1 or 2 months, I would suggest it's good to apply now, have it changed, whether the rules or relaxation change or not. They're turning 50, if they have time at their end, it's better to apply now and have the OCI card renewed. Renewal does not take 2 months. It takes about 3 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. Let's keep upper limit as 1 month, it will come back. Generally, what happens that when you apply for OCI, either for the fresh or the renewal application, our team verifies the passport and then returns the US passport immediately, so that if you have any other travel in the intervening period, you can take it upon your US passport. So we application comes to us, it takes about, say, 4 to 5 days to start processing and entering the data. We check the passport, US passport, we return the US passport back to you, and we take the application further for processing. At the end of 1 month, you'll get your renewed OCI card as well for those who are turning 50. So if you don't have any immediate travel currently planned now, it's better to get renewed at this stage.
There are also a lot of questions on young people, kids who've got OCI card and they've now become adults. And of course, their picture has changed. Is there any particular ruling like you have for people turning 50 for the young people, kids who've got OCI card? Is there a certain point when they have to reapply?
Yeah, Raji, let me just put it clear, make clear the rules regarding OCI. A lot of confusion. It started, I think, in 2019 when government clarified this position. There was a lot of uproar, a lot of confusion among the community, which is natural because, a lot of rumors has been spread, started being spread as well. Till people turn 20, people have to renew their OCI card. These are normal rules. Let me just stress again, not for the COVID protocol. All this renewal has been extended till 30th of June. Okay, but the normal rules say that till people turn 20, they have to renew their OCI card every time that passport is renewed. Okay, let's understand the reason why. It's because people change their appearance. A 5-year-old kid will not look the same at the end of 10 years or 12 years. So whenever they change the passport, they have to change their OCI card till they turn 20. Once they turn 20 and then have an OCI card issued after they turn 20, that OCI card is valid till they turn 50. That's because people don't change much from between 20 to 50. It's easy for every immigration or immigration officials to, you know, verify the OCI and the existing passport and then assume that it belongs to the same person. So 20 to 50, no need to change the OCI card. But once they turn 50, they have to change the OCI card again for the rest of their life. These are three rules. Till they turn 20, they have to change OCI. They renew their OCI every time a new passport is issued. After they turn 20, they have to get the OCI renewed once, and that is valid till they turn 50. And after they turn 50, they need to renew their OCI for the rest of their life. These are the three simple rules. Any queries, any questions will definitely address in this regard also. But all renewal has been deferred till 30th June, considering the special circumstances under COVID pandemic.
Those who hold PIO cards, should they be converting to OCI?
Adi, it is advisable to convert into OCI if they don't have any imminent travel pending before them in the next 1 or 2 months. But PIO conversion has been extended till 31st December 2021. There is a longer period given for PIO to OCI conversion. If they have to take up immediate travel, they can use the PIO card and travel right now. But if they have time at their disposal, I would recommend that it's better to have it converted into an OCI.
For the emergency visa, can one just send everything online, or hard copy of the documentation still needs to be submitted in order to obtain the emergency visa?
No, hard copies have to be sent. Instructions in this regard are on our website as to what all is required to be sent with the visa application. So first, the form has to be filled online on indianvisaonline.gov.in, which is a paper visa application. You have to fill the application online, upload a photograph, take a printout, and then send it to the consulate with passport, fees, and documents which are listed on our website. So physical copies have to be sent to us.
And Mr. Desai, thank you very much. And then I think my able colleagues will handle all the questions which are coming. But no, let us keep it to only consular issues, the queries, and then no. And some people are questioning, no, 50 years of age, etc. This is a policy which government of India has taken. And then we even don't question. No, they have a right to question, but they can write a mail or so, which we will forward to government of India. And no, our colleagues and my office is ready to meet challenge. On a lighter note, if no one asks visa yesterday, that's it. So we can do all other things. So, and on passports, in my few months here, I experienced, we all know Bay Area, no? It's all highly educated, and then no, Silicon Valley. So just to know, they will be busy with their own work, I know. But you know, we have given a window of 1 year before expiry of passport, they can apply. If they do that, they will not have their rush of, no, they need to apply for some form, no, some other status change, etc. That will be solved. No, within 1 year, they can apply anytime. And then, no, it takes, no, a month or so. So it is easy for us to deal with such cases instead of, no, last minute rush. So this is only my guideline. They need not take it as a command or so. So with this, no, I really would like to spend entire time with this kind of group, no, to know more from the other side. But I need to go. Thank you very much, Rade.
Thanks so much. I'm quickly scrolling through, you know, now 358 questions. I think many relating to OCI, I think we've kind of addressed that. And I think, as has been mentioned, the website has a lot of very important information, procedural, you know, what documents have to be submitted. And one really needs to take time, make the effort to ensure that in filing an application, you are in compliance with all of the requirements, then you know there are no holdups. On the emergency visa application, I think the question keeps coming up, which is, you know, in this current lockdown situation with the offices closed, are there any facilities offered to really very urgent need for somebody to like catch a flight tomorrow? What possibilities exist for such emergency situation that an individual may have?
I think Rajji, the Consul General already responded to that and said that if there is a death in the family and someone has to travel urgently, we do take applications directly at the consulate, but only in death cases. Secondly, this is a general statement, not meant for anyone specific in this group. A lot of people tend to book tickets and then use that as an excuse to put pressure on the consulate to issue visas. I think the rule is that you should obtain a visa first and then book your tickets. But in cases of emergency, like we mentioned, in death cases where someone has to travel urgently, we do process visas the same way.
Rajji, there are many questions that keep coming. There are very specific questions that people are asking as well. As you said, mostly a lot of concern about OCI card renewal post 50. Yeah. Normally, it has to be renewed once people turn 50. But if you are on urgent travel, you can use your existing OCI card till 30th June this year. What it is meant for, those who have certain emergencies that come up in their families back in India. You have time. You don't have any travel plan in the next 1 or 2 months. Please get it renewed. It is safer. It's always good to do it in advance. As a general comment, Rajji, I just would like to mention, COVID has come in and disrupted probably all services, be it United States government, be it Indian government, any other government. Every service has been disrupted because the procedures that we put in place, the systems that we put in place has not been working. We have really have to innovate with newer mechanism, newer systems to address this pandemic. And the challenge, the added challenge on our end is that we always thought this is a temporary measure. It's going to go away, but that's not happening. We have the standard procedures, which we cannot follow, unfortunately. We brought in this emergency system, which unfortunately had to be continued. It's been 8 months now. We're still having these emergency measures. Hopefully, we will get rid of these systems very soon. And also, in addition to the COVID situation, procedural issues, there are safety and health protocols that are very strictly enforced by the local authority that affects our service provider, VFS, that affects the consulate as well. We would love to provide visas to people for every type of emergency, seen or unseen, foreseen emergencies. But unfortunately, here we have strict regulations. Local authorities have time and again taken it up with us saying that, okay, please ensure that you entertain minimum number of people at your consulate. Please ensure that whoever comes maintain social distance, wears the mask and all that. They don't want to see us as another hotspot in San Francisco. We have to abide by their restrictions. We have to abide by their concern they have shown to us and the relaxation they've given to us that we can take cases pertaining to, very extreme emergencies such as death cases and all that. But we'll not be able to extend it for other cases because, there's some sort of an understanding we have entered with the local authorities abiding by their request and then, meeting our requirement as a consular service agency. Rajji, just want to mention some of the general principles since we have this 500 plus audience viewers here. In these unusual circumstances, there are certain general rules if we follow that will help all of us. Example, it's better always to apply well in advance. Don't wait for an emergency to pop up. If your parents, relatives, somebody undergoing some challenges back home, you see that there's a travel that we have to undertake the next 15 days, please send us the visa application. We'll definitely help you out. If you don't have any document, the doctor has not given certificate and all that, you can always write a letter to Consul General saying that this, I foresee this emergency popping up in 15 days. I would like to have a visa at my disposal that will be valid for next 6 months. And secondly, when you make an application, please avoid common mistakes. As Madam mentioned, we do get applications where it may not happen. Probably it may not, willfully it may not happen, but it these things do happen. People forget to sign, people forget to mention their passport applications properly. People don't mention their telephone numbers in the online application. These are all the procedural requirement on which consulate does not have any control. And you know, when an application is not complete, probably we will not have any option but to return the application, and this adds to the delay. And before posting the application, please double check, please ensure that you have met all the requirements. Please ensure that you added the money. We take only money orders or cashier checks. No personal checks, no cash. Okay, please ensure that you abide by these conditions and you post the application. Double check before you post and always add a written envelope as mentioned in our guidelines. And you have applied for some services, be it passport, be it visa, OCI, and 15 days you haven't heard anything. You're welcome to reach out to us. Our email ID, someone asking, Consul General email ID, please go to the website. All our email IDs are given. We have an emergency email for all kinds of queries, oci2.sf. I'm going to type in the common chat. Until yesterday, when my staff left, who was in charge of that email, who left, she showed me that there are zero emails pending. We'll not be able to address those things in the next today and tomorrow emails. You can always give a ring on our emergency number if there is an emergency. There is not an emergency, please write to us on that email. You'll definitely get a response within 24 hours. And again, I would like to reemphasize, please go to our website. Please read the instruction on our website. Please do not listen to some gyanis on the blogs. People mislead, people give wrong information. Please don't listen to them. Any queries, any doubts, go to our website. Something is not clear, write to our OCI2. Write to us. We'll get back. We'll answer all your queries. And our website is very, very frequently updated. Our last update happened 2 days before. Okay, all current information, all necessary information will be updated. Please visit our website. That will answer all many of your queries. If still you have doubts, you're welcome to reach out to us. These are some common guidance. Common guidelines. I just wanted to share it with the group here.
Excellent. I think another question coming up is if many seniors do visit between India and here pretty regularly. If they've had both of the vaccines and they have a card showing that they've had both shots, do they still require a COVID negative test to make their travel?
Raji, this was taken up with Delhi, and we heard back from Delhi saying that, you know, people do require COVID negative tests regardless whether they are vaccinated or not vaccinated, because internationally a pattern is yet to arrive, yet to be agreed upon for vaccinated versus non-vaccinated people, and governments across the world are not prepared to take the risk. So it's always safer to have a COVID, it's necessary to have a COVID negative test uploaded in the necessary form. Our FAQs on our website, but as you enter cgisf.gov.in website, a pop-up comes in that there is an FAQ that is updated 2 days back with the latest information. It gives the clear guidelines as to where to upload your COVID negative test. As of now, people have to upload COVID negative test. We also have our colleagues from VFS. You know, probably I can request Ashok, who is the manager at VFS, intervene and give some of his views, some of the do's and don'ts, and what are the frequent challenges they encounter with the application they receive, and how they can process an application fast, and what are the applications they get stuck up at their end and adds to the delay. It will be helpful. Ashok, can you just share some of your insights?
Sure. Thank you, Mr. Rajesh. First of all, let me take this opportunity to thank Mr. Desai for the invite. It's a pleasure to participate in this event. And as Mr. Rajesh mentioned, I'm Ashok, a zone manager for VFS Global based in San Francisco. I'm joined by my colleague, Elena, who's the San Francisco Center Operation Manager. What we are planning to do is briefly, we're going to run through, you know, the process, how to, you know, submit an application for a passport or OCI, any consular services through VFS website. And also, as Mr. Rajesh requested, you know, we'll talk about some common mistakes, you know, made by the applicants, you know, while signing their application. So that will help, you know, as to reduce the incomplete applications that we have and process it in a straightforward manner. For anyone applying for passport, OCR renunciation, or a GEP, except the visa part, they can start the process with VFS website. I've mentioned the website address by the right side. Or even, someone can Google VFS, India Consular Application Center, this will pick up on Google search. So the homepage, pretty much has the link for all services, as you can see, passport, OCI, renunciation, GEP, and it's pretty user-friendly, website. And it has the step-by-step, process, which will easily guide, the applicant to complete the process. The first step is, for the applicant to fill after going through the process, there will be links, for the applicants to be redirected to the government, respective government portal, be it passport or OCI. And then they fill up the application form, on the government portal, complete the process and take a printout of the application form and generate the government reference number. And then they come back to, VFS website to continue with the process to complete and to make the payment as well. So this step-by-step, is there for each and every service on our website. So first they identify the service type, if it's passport, what service, passport renewal or new passport, or minor or adult, they'll have to select. And then they begin the application and going to the government portal to complete the process and then come back to VFS website to register and to complete the payment process as per the services they have selected. And once they complete the payment, then they'll be they'll have to send the physical application by mail to VFS office. So once we receive it, we process it, and then we send the application to the consulate for further processing. So this is pretty much the process, and as I mentioned, website is user friendly, and we highly recommend everybody to go through the FAQs on the website because we constantly update all the queries, repeated queries that we're getting from the applicants on the FAQs. The FAQ covers most of the general inquiries coming in. So if one has to go through the FAQ, they'll be able to understand most of the questions will be answered. And now I request my colleague Alina, who's the subject matter expert, to run through this common mistakes made by the applicant so that it's clear, and then we can try to avoid this going forward.
Thank you, Ashok. Thank you, Mr. Raj Desai and the Indian community for inviting us for this virtual meeting. So I'd like to go through the common mistakes that we usually go through every day. So common is the parental authorization form for minors for OCI. We get a lot of application wherein instead of filling and submitting the parental authorization form minor for OCI, instead they're submitting the form for renunciation. So for each department, there is a specific form mentioning what service is being applied for and authorizing the consulate to issue. So if your parental authorization form says renunciation, but you're applying for OCI, your application will be placed on hold until you submit the correct form. The naturalization certificate is not signed. It is important that the naturalization certificate holder signed the certificate, the original certificate itself, and make a copy. And then the photograph, we also have the photograph specification posted on our website. The common mistake is it's not in the right size. It has to be 2x2. It has to be in a white plain background. and uploading the uploaded photograph in the government website has to be identical to the photograph that being submitted. I understand some applicants, they don't have the passport photo available. What they do is they just upload their old photo just to finish the online application form and then take a new photo, but forgetting to update the uploaded image online. So just ensure that the physical photo and the uploaded photo has to be identical, and the photograph has to be taken, must be recent, taken at least the past 6 months. Now, common mistake as well on the data entry is when applicants enter the names of their parents and spouse, not exactly as in their Indian passport. So let's say if the parents or spouse have a middle name and you only enter the given name and the last name, there must be a supporting documents for such change. Right now, the embassy give a leniency to this rule that if you cannot provide supporting documents for such change, you can actually provide us a consent to restore the old details of your parents or spouse as in your Indian passport so that the application can move forward. So it is very important that before you save your online application, you have to make sure that every details that you enter on the government website must be as in your supporting documents, because the government website will not allow you to go back and make edits. And that will actually delay the process. Either your application will be rejected or will be put on hold for supporting documents for such data entry issue. Affidavit in lieu of originals. This is actually mentioned in our checklist. However, many applicants tend to forget to send this important affidavit. So it is important that before submitting the application by post, please go through the checklist and make sure every single document that's mentioned in the checklist is met.